carbonara. It's one of Rome's most iconic dishes, and it's served everywhere. But for a really unforgettable one, you must visit the king. Luciano Monosilio has been called the king of carbonara, in a city where carbonara is king. Everything about Luciano is generous. His smile, his laughter, his talent. He says yes to everything we ask, including his secret carbonara recipe.
This is really a gift. Grazie.
Okay. This carbonara is not the traditional way to how to make carbonara, but it's my recipe. We start from the first thing is the guanciale.
Okay.
Guanciale is from the, is the cheek.
The cheek of the guancia, the cheek of the pork.
The seasoning of guanciale have to be more or less 4 months.
4 months curing.
Yeah, okay.
Okay.
So, second thing is very important. So we have to remove everything. Skin.
Luciano removes the thick skin and all the pepper that coats the guanciale.
After we cut the guanciale in a small cube.
Oh la la, look at those beautiful layers of fat.
After we start making the carbonara sauce.
Look, only egg yolks.
It's dorato.
Yes.
It's gold. The chickens eat corn and carrots. That's why the yolk is so like golden orangey.
Black pepper.
Black pepper on the yolk.
Then there's the cheese.
We mix the grana and the pecorino romano dop.
No.
One part of one, grana.
One part of grana.
And two.
Two parts of pecorino romano DOP.
And then we mix it.
Ah. Now that's the difference. Nobody does this.
I don't think so. Now everyone knows my secret. So.
It's so. Okay. In the end, it's your hand, Luciano.
Yeah, yes. We use the iron pan. We warm up a little bit the pan.
Okay.
After warm up the pan, we put the guanciale. You see, without olive oil.
No more fat,
no butter, no anything.
Just the fat of the guanciale.
Guanciale, yes.
Luciano happens to be one of the youngest Michelin-starred chefs in Rome. He gained his first Michelin star in Pipero al Rex when he was just 27 years old and already a sensation. And that's where I first met him. When the guanciale starts to fry, Luciano says lower the heat because it shouldn't burn. With the guanciale done, we start on the pasta. All the pasta served here is made in-house.
When we do the carbonara, the pasta don't have to be really, really al dente.
Okay.
Why? Because we have to put the pasta inside the bowl. Okay.
And no more heat.
We put some water.
Yeah.
Okay.
And no more flame.
We mix. We do this carbonara like this. But on bain-marie, like this.
Oh my God.
Bain-marie. So that's the Luciano technique. Makes perfect sense. Luciano says this way he has complete control of the temperature. He openly says he learned to make carbonara the classic way when he worked at Roscioli. But this is the Luciano version, which took him all of 2 years to perfect.
It's done. We finished with the cold guanciale, but I have to be cold.
Notice the guanciale needs to be room temperature, not hot. Because if not, the egg si cuoce.
Yes.
No?
And the carbonara, you see? It's very creamy, smoothie. Oh. Also the pasta, it looks like pasta all'uovo. Because the cream is very thick.
Golden, creamy, decadent, carbonara at Luciano is all of the above.
My hero. Dai, Luciano.
Fatto. Allora, I finished with the guanciale on top. We are generous here in Italy.
Okay,
you know
si.
And the black pepper in here, on top.
Ooh la la!
You see? Oh. How you feel? Oh. How you feel?
Oh. No words.
Thank you.
Senza parola.
Thank you. Bravo.
Complimenti, bravo.
Bravo.
The best.
Now, carbonara for everybody.
Okay, let's go.
Carbonara party.
Come on.
As it turns out, his secret recipe is given out to all his customers in the form of this yellow card. Should you be so lucky to get a reservation at Luciano's Cucina Italiana.